This installment of Maps and Movies, we're going to be talking about What We Do in the Shadows. This is a mockumentary done by Taika Waititi and Jemaine Clement. It follows a group of vampires that live in the same flat in New Zealand. Their adventures and their trouble paying rent and doing daily activities. They have a chore wheel.
Put out the recycling, which was really cool.
And the other day, I dragged the man's body down the hallway and noticed that there was no dust. Like I kind of swept the hallway.
It's been like this the whole time, okay? So
Viago was a little pedantic.
The washing and the rubbish, I did that. Deacon on dishes, and it still hasn't moved in 5 years.
He was an 18th century dandy, so he can be very fussy.
Nags and nags.
I went in the lounge the other day, and there was blood all over my nice antique couch.
Which one, the red one?
Well, it's red now, yeah.
This movie was brought to my attention by a commenter named Thea May in my last installment of Maps and Movies. She said that the funniest GIS reference in film is probably in this movie right here, and I'd never heard of it. It turns out that these vampires befriend a human, which causes a lot of interesting scenes, and he is a GIS analyst. In this scene, Stu is describing what he does for a living to a woman in a nightclub, and it's pretty typical to how most people describe what they do or what happens.
Data about where things are.
Oh, like Google Maps stuff.
Yeah, kind of like Google Maps, but like more layers of information.
The movie Twilight. Have you seen it?
That scene I thought was pretty funny because it seems like every time I try to describe what I do for a living, usually Google Maps enters the conversation somehow. So I thought that was pretty funny. If you have a funny way that you describe what you do, why don't you put it down in the comments? I've heard all sorts of stuff, how people describe what they do when they do GIS. Stu is actually a friend of Nick's, who is a brand new vampire and isn't quite familiar with the rules of being a vampire. He was made a vampire by these flatmates, and they're trying to show him how to be a real vampire, and he brings Stu around, and the flatmates really enjoy him because he's showing them all the technology and everything. Anyway, this is Nick's introduction of Stu.
This is my friend Stu.
Hey, he works in computers and stuff. Oh, yeah, like computer-based stuff, hey, mainly.
Yeah. Geodatabases.
Yeah, like computers mainly.
In this scene, everybody's attending a vampire social, the biggest vampire social of the year in New Zealand, and Nick brings Stu along, and it's a big mistake, but this is what happens.
This was a total misunderstanding. There was on the invitation, and this actually pertains to you, the invitation, it said plus one, but it did not specify
if it could
be a human or if it could be a werewolf.
Stu, tell them what you do.
Come on, Stu, tell us what you do.
Tell them what you do, Stu.
Hi, my name's Stu.
Louder.
Hi, my name is Stu. I work in IT.
I can't hear.
Louder. Stu, they can't hear you. They cannot hear you.
Hi, my name's Stu. I'm a software analyst. I work for a geographic information systems company.
What is it?
I work for a company that does... basically, we take like business requirements from organizations and we analyze those requirements and then we build software to fit those requirements.
He's a virgin. She's a virgin.
I can smell a virgin at 1,000 paces.
Go on then. Go 1,000 paces there where you can smell yourself.
So just a quick disclaimer here. What We Do in the Shadows is rated R because it deals with adult themes. I mean, it has vampires in it, so there's a lot of blood. But I watched it with a service called VidAngel, which allows you to filter content based on what you choose. It has individual filters for different scenes, and you can select whether you want to see that content or not. It's a really handy service. It filtered it out. I didn't notice any skips or jumps that made watching the film annoying. It was pretty smooth and enjoyable. So there you have it. That's What We Do in the Shadows. If you've seen a movie or a TV show that features a really cool map or a GIS person in it, let me know in the comments and I'll work up another video about it. Thanks for watching. I'm out.